Music is one of the most essential pieces to any project, whether that's a scripted narrative, doc, or client work. So today we're going to take a look at working with music inside of Premiere Pro. So we have this talking head clip from my show Film Riot that we need to add some music onto. You can find royalty-free music pretty much anywhere online. We use subscription services like Artlist and MusicBed, and you can also find free tracks on sites like Incompetech or YouTube's Audio Library, and of course, Adobe Stock with their free music and sound effects there, which is now built inside of Premiere's Essential Sound panel. But honestly, how to choose the right track for your project could be an entire episode of its own. You really need to understand the tone and tempo of the moment that you're wanting to add your music into. We show examples of how disastrous this can be if you choose the wrong music on our show Film Riot plenty of times. But let's look at this moment with the music that lands how I intended. And now let's look at it with the completely wrong music. It's a funny and extreme example, but you get the idea. So when you're choosing your tracks, listen emotionally. Is the tempo right? Is the tone hitting exactly where it needs to? It's hard to fully quantify this process. Sometimes it's really just trial and error. After all the trial and error, we'll drop in our selected track and always find one of two issues. Either your music track is too long in duration or too short. You have a few options here, like manually adjusting the track. If it's too long, it's easy enough to just drag it back, but if you need it to end and don't want to just fade out, I'll often find an ending point in the track, trim to that, and then add that to a moment that it can connect to. This is easy enough most of the time since you can find a sync point using the beats in the track. You can use the waveform to find that, but most importantly, your ears. Then you're going to want to make your connection on a hit if possible. Add a short transition on the cut, and there you have it. If the track doesn't have an obvious usable ending, you could stop the track using a reverb. For this, we'll find a beat to stop our track on. Again, I'm using the waveform to find that here. Then I'll make my cut to isolate the track, right-click, and nest. Go inside the nest and duplicate this track. Then we're gonna extend it out a couple of seconds, then right-click and uncheck enable. Doing this will allow you to extend your nest. So back in your main sequence, we're gonna extend that nest a few seconds. Then we're gonna go to effects, audio effects, reverb, and drop on a studio reverb. Change the preset to Great Hall, and you're done. The Remix tool uses AI to seamlessly shorten or elongate tracks. This is especially helpful when you need an underbed track to last longer. To access it, click and hold the Ripple Edit tool to reveal other options, then find the Remix tool at the bottom. Once selected, we can extend or shorten the track, and within seconds, Premiere will make the necessary cuts to have your track fit within the desired timeframe. You can also do this by selecting your track, opening up your Essential Sound panel, checking the duration box, and for the method, tap Remix. Now type in your target duration, and Premiere will do its thing. With your music track selected and timed properly, the final step is to mix it in so it doesn't overpower any vocals. If I solo the vocal track here, you can see that our levels are landing in between -3 and -15 dB. So to avoid the music being too loud, I'll solo the music track and lower the volume until it reaches somewhere around -30 dB. This should give you a good starting point, but it's important to listen through and adjust as needed since this will vary pretty much every time. But it also depends on what you want your piece to feel like. And you can also drop on a simple parametric EQ to lower the music volume wherever the vocal frequencies are living. So back on my music track, I'll set the center to those frequencies, the Q to 4, and the boost to -18 dB. Now, since we notched out that frequency from the music, more space has been made for the voice to sit clearly in that pocket. But those are a few tips on how you can work with music inside of your project. And of course, there's so much more to get into. And if there's something specific around music that you would like us to get into, feel free to put that in the comments below. And subscribe to the channel for more tutorials and updates like this one, because giraffes are 30 times more likely to get hit by lightning than people. That's actually true.